Hello everyone, and welcome to a new Cyberpunk 2077 video. Today we're gonna play Phantom Liberty DLC, and I want to show how I can get another weapon. Probably this is one of my of the most powerful weapon that I have, and let me tell you, with this thing I just managed to shoot and kill with only one shot three different enemies. I'm not sure if I have another weapon that it's so strong like this one. You're gonna set your enemies on fire, you're gonna make them explode, you're gonna have a lot of fun. In the first part of the video, I'm gonna show just a little bit the weapon, how it works, what you can do to your enemies, and remember, you can still upgrade it. Yes, the one that you are seeing is not upgraded. This is the stock version of the weapon, not the stock, the one that I just got without doing any upgrade. You can upgrade it up to tier 5++, and it's gonna be insane. Also, with the perfect build, I cannot even imagine what you can do, because yes, I don't have the points put all over the place for this weapon. I have my points just random, so I have a random build, a good build, but is not prepared for this weapon. Definitely what you are seeing can make it way much stronger. I'm level 60, so these enemies that you are seeing that you are seeing right now are quite strong. Yeah, if you don't know the enemies in this game, they're gonna adapt based on your level, and we have some pretty strong ones, but they cannot just... So if you aim right, and if you are quite close to your target, they will not survive. Depends how you aim. Yes, I put some of these parts on fast forward. I just want to show you some fun. That's it. That's why I put some of these parts on fast forward, and I decided to find some stronger enemies, not bosses, but a little bit stronger enemies. And I think an enemy a little bit stronger, it will be right over here. Up here it is. With one bullet or two, I just took. I don't know. This thing is strong. Please tell me, which one is your favorite weapon in this game? I think in matter of shotguns and also power guns, I think this is for me one of the best at this moment. The first or the second, I'm not sure, because I have another new shotgun which is quite good. I don't know which I prefer, but I think this one maybe. Not sure. Please tell me, what do you think? Okay, I think it's time for me to show you how you can actually get the weapon, what you have to do in order to get the weapon. You have to start this gig, the man who killed Jason Foreman, and you can find this gig right over here. Just go to that area. I'm not sure when it's gonna be available, but probably if you go to the area that I'm about to show you on the map, you can just start it. So just go to the area and start the gig, the man who killed Jason Foreman. Then you have to proceed with the quest. By the way, I already have the quest on my YouTube channel. If you want to check it out, yes, it's already there. So you can just watch what I did. What are all the options that you have? You have three different options to finish this job, this gig. So you have three different outcomes. Depends which one do you want to take. Right. But if you want to take the weapon, there is only one. I'm not sure if you're gonna take other than this one that I'm about to show you. If you can just go to the garage and to put the code that I'm about to show you. I'm not sure. I have to admit, I didn't try it. But the perfect version of how you can get the weapon is gonna put... you don't have to kill him after this dialogue. You're gonna have this dialogue at a certain point. Don't kill him. Get his tag. And then, in a short period of time, you're gonna get the Rinder dog tag. It's very important. You cannot complete the mission without that. And after that, after you're gonna get his tag, all you have to do is to exit the building, and you're gonna receive a message with a code. And obviously, in this video, I'm showing the garage. Where is that garage, and how can put the code? Because I told you, I'm not sure if you're gonna take another outcome, another ending, another dialogue option. And if you put the code 1971, what will be the code? Let's see. Okay, let's head out. This is the location underneath this building, and the Rinder stash. We're gonna put the code that I just got to the message. Here it is, the location. 1975 will be the code. Again, I'm not sure if you can come here earlier to get the weapon. You can just come here to try, but probably not. This is in the dog town. Okay, And you can loot a lot of awesome thing, awesome stuff from this location also. The location where you are, I think, is the Terra Cognita fast travel point, the one that you just saw earlier. So underneath those buildings, there is gonna be this secret stash. Get the weapon and enjoy it. I hope you enjoyed this video. You got all the information, and I hope you're gonna have a good day today. Love you all. Like, subscribe, share, press that notification bell. I'm gonna see you really soon with another awesome video. Bye. And yes, I just got a deserter, my new awesome iconic weapon. And by the way, I have most of the weapons, if not all. I'm not sure if I have them all, but I have a ton of new weapons on my YouTube channel that you can just take if you are watching those videos. Bye.